Hey guys, Keel Lancer here. Want to never Keel Lancer Gaming. Don't forget the bell button, subscribe button to get notifications to my channel. All right, guys, we got some gaming news right here with Marvel Spider-Man and the Marvel's Avengers game. As you can see, got my Cap shirt on. Cap is one of my favorite characters, along with Hawkeye, the Incredible Hulk, and also Hawkeye. But let's dive up into this information. This article was done by Andy Robinson. Marvel says Spider-Man and Avengers game are set in their own universe, which we already knew that already, but I like hearing other people's opinions, okay? So Marvel's new wave of big-budget licensed video games, each exist in their own Marvel universe. The film's games boss said, speaking in a wide-range Entertainment Weekly feature, this week Marvel Games head of creative Bill Roseman explained how different game narratives currently coexist. Despite the success of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, Marvel isn't actively overlapping its universe of interconnected games yet, Rossman reportedly told the publication. Which I think they should hurry up and get that on the ball while the hype is still there, even though the next cinematic universe is going to be trash. Okay? All right, each game is in the Marvel Universe, but they are in their own reality, if you will. He said, currently our plan is to keep each game set in their own Marvel Universe. Fans had previously speculated that Marvel Avengers PlayStation exclusive Spider-Man could be the same character featured in the platform's owned record-selling Spider-Man game, but Roseman comments along with Insomniac's own origin explanations confirmed that that's not the case, which that's fine, okay? Following decades of success in cinema and comics, Marvel recently enjoyed its biggest video game success to date with PlayStation Spider-Man, which has sold an exact of 13 million units, making it the best-selling superhero video game. Roseman said the success was all about timing. So I'm guessing it did better than the Arkham series. I'm guessing as in a whole. It's all about what talent is available. Do they want to work with Marvel? If so, what's their passion? When you have all those things aligned, that's when you can create something great. He added, "We always believe in the power of video games. We're happy that more people than ever are discovering, even though you may be physically in different areas, that the games can bring you together and create connections." Spider-Man Miles Morales is set to release for PlayStation 5 later this year. Marvel's Avengers is set to release September 4th. Current gen consoles and PC Avengers is also set to launch on next gen consoles later this year, and owners of the current gen version will be able to upgrade to no additional cost, which is cool. Okay, what I want to talk about on this video as well, with the news and stuff like that, Sony had literally got the exclusive for Spider-Man just to be on the PlayStation, which is terrible news for everybody who specifically was buying the game in hopes of eventually Spider-Man will probably be released as DLC for each and every one of the systems in the PC. Personally, I guess for me, is I'm seeing it as, you know, hey, Sony has the movie rights and probably the toy rights and all that other good stuff. And they also have the Spider-Man game rights with Insomniac and stuff like that. I'm like, okay, it's no big deal. But the bad thing is that Spider-Man brings money. If Spider-Man is on all the consoles, that will sell each and every copy on all the consoles, even the PC, which is understandable, you know, if it was done that way. But Sony, which is doing something dirty and keeping it for themselves, it actually hurt the game, even though it hurts me to even say that, because I'm like, okay, they own Spider-Man movie rights and they had the Spider-Man game, why not do it that way? But it doesn't work that way at the same time too. All you're gonna do is hurt yourselves for the game, and this game needs to be sold on all consoles. Now, if they were smart, they would have exclusives for each and every one of the consoles, like Xbox Series X, Xbox, and all that other good stuff, and PC and stuff like that, if they do it that way. But Spider-Man is just universal. Spider-Man is, you know, he's just one of those characters where everybody has to have the characters. Now, Ultimate Alliance is one of the other games that you can play as Spider-Man, which is on the Nintendo Switch. It was exclusive on Nintendo Switch. You know, Nintendo bought the rights you know, for that the Ultimate Alliance franchise to be on that system, just like Sony bought the rights for Spider-Man to be only on the PS4 system, which is fair. And then you have Xbox at the same time, where they don't have anything Spider-Man related, but they can just exclusively have it for their specific console, which is crazy. And then if you think about it, Xbox should, in my opinion, should go the DC route. If you want DC games, you have to buy the Xbox. I wouldn't be too mad at that, because you have, you know, PlayStation buying the rights specifically for Spider-Man to be on their console. Why not do it with DC? It'll be smart. And in each and one of those consoles, they can have their own exclusives to it, but also they can have other things that will come with the games as well. That's just in my opinion. That's just what I think. But let me know what you guys think in the comment section below, guys. Don't forget the bell button, the subscribe button to get notifications to my channel, guys. Don't forget the thumbs up button, guys. That definitely helps me in the algorithm. And also, that also allows me to think that, you know, you guys are enjoying the content as well. That's why I look at the like button as well, guys. But this is Kill Lancer. We got more gaming news coming up.